1975, I was hired at Electric Lady Studios to be an apprentice engineer in training. I didn't know anything about it. I was sitting in the lobby late one night, because that was the only safe place to smoke pot. Somebody came in the door, down the stairs. It was Eddie Kramer, the famous engineer, one of the designers of Electric Lady, and four guys behind him who were Led Zeppelin. And Eddie swept into the lobby and said, "Where's my assistant?" And the night manager said, "Well, I don't have you booked." And he says, "Well, I need a room and I need an assistant right now." And he pointed to me, you're my assistant. So I followed the band back into the studio and did my best to set up. Eddie was barking orders at me, and Jimmy Page was helping me. Every chance he got, he would look at me and whisper something that I was supposed to do. He was really a good guy. So I worked with them for about 3 days. One of the nights, it was snowing, the studio door opens, and two guys walk in. One of them's wearing a parka over his head, covered with snow. And I jumped up, he knocked off the snow and pushed back the parka, and it was Mick Jagger. The band was busy, so they said their pleasantries and Mick left.
The project we were working on was remixing The Song Remains the Same, the live album.
They were doing occasional overdubs for notes that they had blown on stage. So Jimmy Page would go out and do a little bit of guitar. Robert Plant went out and he did the big yell in Whole Lot of Love. They were all very nice guys, as opposed to some of the bands I worked with there. We'll talk about that another time. But I very much enjoyed working on the album and feeling like I was a small part of it.